know what, we've had a journey together, we've had equipment failures, we've had everything, we've had all these people, but we finally got there. They jumped to the final section. Give a big round of applause for the final section! We've got three acts in this section, we're going to whiz through this section, we'll have loads of fun. They've got to give as much love as you've got, so on the count of three, one, two, three, there's a clapping! Jimmy Woodman, please go to the stage, Jimbo!
Thank you. chair. You know when you're a polite, easygoing person like me? Any polite, easygoing people in here? Stick your hand up. I want to see you. Yeah, there's a lady there. Yeah, you're a polite, easygoing person. I can see that. But don't you get shat on!
Yes!
Yeah, yes! Another easygoing person, they get shat on! Yes. They get shat on all the time! Do you know what? I was at a comedy festival last weekend, right? I was doing the evening show, and this comedian, I have met the cleverest man in the world. Yes, I have. I'll tell you about it. I was doing a comedy festival at the weekend, right? And this guy comes up to me after I've done my act. And he was surprising that he was the cleverest man in the world. He was a comedian. Yeah, this guy, will you give me a lift home? I said, well, how did you get here? He said, I got a lift by another guy. And I said, well, why aren't you going back? He said, well, I decided to spend the weekend at the festival and not go back with him. Right, so me, in my mind, when he said, can you give me a lift home, there's a little voice in my brain saying, ask him for some petrol money. Ask him for some petrol money. And what did I do? Oh no, I can't do that. I'm much too polite to do that. So I drove him home, right? And on the way home, he's jabbering all the time. I can't hear the sat nav. I get lost. It takes me fucking ages to find a way back. On the motorway, he's jabbering all the time. He's quizzing me like I'm in Guantanamo fucking Bay. I can't concentrate on my driving. I nearly have accidents. I have to slow down. And when we get back, he says, there's this little voice in my head again. This little voice. And it's going, ask him for some petrol money now. This is your last chance. Ask him now. What did I do? No. No, that's how I can't do that. Spoil the rapport. He might give me some money as he's getting out of the car. Did you give me any money? Daddy, fuck! All that night, I got this voice in my head saying, I told you to ask him to come pick him up. Why didn't you fucking ask him? You should have asked him. All night I couldn't fucking sleep. All the next night I couldn't fucking sleep. And do you know what? He gave me some clues before I put him in the car. He gave me some clues like, I'm glad a VIP pass. I've been blagging drinks all over the showground. I've been blagging hamburgers, beef burgers, chocolate burgers, all sorts of fucking things. And do you know why he didn't go out with another guy? He wouldn't have to give him some petrol money. That tight bastard. And do you know what? It cost me more to take him home. Do you know Did you hear about the Liverpool thing? In hospital there, they're stopping.
Thank you.
We don't need it, I told you. I don't need that fucking thing. Was it time?
I tried to stay, you know, white south.
Fuck me! Dawson, 2 minutes, go fast.
No.
Anyway.
2 minutes, sorry.
You've been a fetcher. Hey, could you hear me in the back?
Thank you.